Hi, I'm Pasupai Lavanazo, Primary 6 from Yumi Primary School. In this lesson, we'll continue with Calculus, Chapter 7, Double and Triple Integral. For the past few lessons, we have done examples of this double integral. And we realized that we can also use single integral for this double integral. So one of them, for example, like this. Now if they give you that x, its unit is in meters. Y, its unit is also in meters. Then its coefficient. One has no units, then this would obviously be about area. But there are other types, like for example, all of their unit is meters. If all are meters, then it will be for volume. If these two, the x and the y, are meters, but one is mass density, then it will be about mass. If it is charge density, then it will be about charge. If it is energy density, then it will be for energy. And there's other types. There are many, many types of them. And for this dx, dy, we can take something like a box, and here is dx. Here is dy. So dx is like the length and dy is like the width. But for these, it depends about this double integral, which order you go according to first. There are different ways of adding them together according to the order. So for all of these different types, we'll see what type of examples do we have right now. So for the examples that we have right now, we have an electric charge and it is distributed over the disk. X squared plus y squared is equal to 1. So that is charge density. This is the small sigma. Xy equal to 1 plus x squared plus y squared, and this kc is kilocoulomb per square meters. I will have to calculate the total charge of this disk. When you think about these types of questions, you need to know what their integral region is like. So according to what we are given, it is in a circle. And this circle, something like this. And we have a center somewhere here. Here's the x-axis. And here's the y-axis. This center is at the origin, and its radius is 1. So here's the 1, here's a negative 1, here's also a negative 1, and here's a 1. We have this circle right now. Given its charge density, we'll need to find the total charge. So that means we need to know about its area. Then after we know its area, we'll need to times this. But then the charge density, when you look at this point here, you'll realize it's a 1. And when you look at these four points, that's a 2. So this electric charge is not distributed evenly. This circle it is, well, take one piece, because that it is symmetrical. So positive x, you can also find a negative x with the same charge density. And a positive y, you can also find a negative y on that with also the same charge density. Now when you see this, so for this total charge, we'll use capital Q. We only need to take one quadrant of this. As four quadrants, they are all the same. So we just need to use one quadrant. So this is method one. And when you see that this is a circle, you also think of polar coordinates. Now, can we use it? Of course, yes, we can use it. So 4 times, and we'll need to write this in another form because this is just Cartesian coordinates. Change it into polar coordinates. Then dx dy will become r dr d theta. Let's try, what if we go first according to r? So 0 to 1. Then theta, it will just be from 0 to a half pi. Right now here we can integrate it already. R becomes a half r square plus r cube 1/4 r to the power of 4. Start from 0 to 1, then d theta. So just sub them in. If you sub in 1, it'll become a 3/4. So that's a 3 there. Then 0 is still a 0. Like this, then integrate this part. And sub in again. And what you get is a 3 pi over 2. Its unit Kc, that is kilocoulomb. This is for method number 1. For method number 2, it will be a bit different because, like for example, in this circle, let's just take another circle, a smaller one. Like for example, a circle here. And for this, well, maybe it's something like that. We can take something like a loop out of it. Then that means we can use this. So then first, we need to try to find its area. So this circumference first is 2 pi r. So 2 pi r, then we can find this width. We can call that dr. Then we can times a dr. but we want the charge. So when we want the charge, we need to times that charge density. So it's like this. That means dQ would be a 2 pi r times then for this sigma, okay, let's put this in. But because right now we have this r, so we also need to change that. And that means it'll become a bracket 1 plus r squared, then dr. We can both sides integrate. So q, this would be r, it will be from 0 all the way to 1. Then at this part, oh wait, r. Okay. So that means for this, we have a 2 times pi as the coefficient. Then inside here, r plus r cubed. So r, half r squared plus r cubed, 1/4, I mean this is r to the power 4, then start from 0 to 1, so when you put the 1 in, half plus a 1/4, that will be a 3/4, so 3 pi over 2, then the other is 0, 0 is 0, 0, so the unit kilocoulomb, like this.
This A means area, which equals to the double integral below which is the bound. This S means the boundaries. And then here F, X, Y. D, X, D, Y. Why the most? What will you most likely see when you have a question? You most likely see this integrand, right? Yes, it's correct, but you're only partially correct because there's one more thing you must see. You also need to see the boundaries. So first, let me just tell you about the integrand. So fxy got equals to 1 and not equals to 1. So the not equals to 1, there's many cases. But equals to 1, even though there's a lot of type of units, but let me just say, if got meter, for example, this whole question will be about volume. If no units, then that means this question is about area. Last time, which he used, if it's no unit, means that it's about area. Then this got many cases. Okay? So now for the boundaries. Like that, say because you're calculating the total charge, we usually use the capital Q. So for the capital Q, it equals, since the question says here, the small, it's the small sigma, right? Since it's a small sigma, so let's just use it. Y, dx, dy, boundaries here. So of course, the first thing you say, convert it. So what I mean by convert means because this equals this, so you will just use this part to convert into this. So it becomes 1 plus x squared plus y squared. But don't You know why I tell you not be so fast? Don't just think that you could just separate, okay? There's one thing. Since I'm saying about the general method, and plus state is already the general form. So this, I need to use the general method. I will generalize it so I won't just split. Instead, let me just use something else. So here, for example, I use F, even though here, X and Y, D, X, D, Y. Then after, over here, the boundaries. So here, cool. Since, so let's just change it to the polar coordinates, okay? But it's not the simplest form, means that it's not simply, okay? So here, as x will equals to r cosine theta, and y which equals to r sine theta, something like this, okay? And then let's tell, since it's like this, we already changed it. So here, we have r and theta, so we need it to respect to r and theta. Since we already have r and theta, so you could just write it like, thus. Okay? But, you know that actually there's one more thing I have to write. Let us tell you, in the past, we already calculated before it's RDRD theta, but we calculated in a different way. Do you know how did we calculate it? Look, here, for example, this, and then after that, here you have D theta, right? Then here is R, right? Then here dr, right? Then here you say it's rd theta, like this. As of all, I'm gonna generalize this. I'm not gonna use this. Like this, then you have to, because rd theta, you definitely have drd theta. Partial. You need to use partial differentiation. So here, above is definitely x and y here, and below is r and theta, because that this was respect. So what we need to calculate is this part. This is the most important part. And how shall we calculate it? I just calculate it somewhere here. So you know how should I do this? So here, don't, this might, you may say is something like matching, but let me just tell you it's not. It's actually the Jacobian. Don't confuse Jacobian's determinant with Wronskian's determinant. So let me just write them down, the names. Jacobian determinant and Wronskian determinant. determinant. Something like this, okay? But we are going to just focus on Jacobian determinant, because the Jacobian determinant actually means that if for double, triple, or multiple integral, but Wronskian determinant is for the differential equation, like the homogeneous differential equation, to say is it linear or is it non-linear, okay? So there are different, and that still relates to Gaussian determinant. So this is Jacobian determinant, okay? Don't confuse with those again. So here, partial x over partial r, partial x over partial theta, partial y over partial r, partial y over partial theta. Something like this, okay? So this is something like this. We need to calculate it. Since you already know this part was this here, then just put it in, and so here need to over the r to left cosine theta, then over theta, because then you can't do it. You actually can, except for you need to change it to the sine theta and then the negative or sine theta. Now for this part over r, then sine theta over theta become a cosine, but don't have a negative, so r cosine theta. Now let's calculate it out. So here it become r cosine square theta plus, because negative and negative become positive, or sine theta, which is cos square. Then after that, let's take it out and, the trigonal identity, which is cosine square theta plus sine square theta equals to 1. But you might say that I didn't see that formula, that identity, because that you didn't take out the r yet. If you take out the r, you actually already put it in 1, so r. So here becomes the r d theta. So understand now? So in the general form, you still need to sub it in. So actually, I could just look at this part and sub it in, okay? Integral, which is the double integral, but let me tell you, how I got this answer. Actually, this is from the mapping. The mapping is just something like here, just like here got x and x and y. Here got r and theta. But this now we won't learn the mapping, because there's a mapping in the future we will learn. It actually quite hard. If you understand, no. So here, actually, let's sub it in. So here become 1 plus r squared, because we sub in already. Do you know why? Because that here become r cosine squared theta and r sine squared theta. But because that the r also have a square, so you can take out the r squared, then become this again. Then now for the rd theta. Okay? Something like this. So now, the only thing we have to do is calculate it out. So even though it's quite simple, but if you just look at this formula, you won't really understand. Especially for this mapping part. We need to make sense for this mapping part. So in the future, we'll learn how the mapping is mapping onto. So let me just write it down. Something like this. Here. Then just calculate this out. So we'll have a half. And just erase this, okay? Get a quick look, okay. Becomes theta sub from 0 to 2 pi. Now sub in. Now simplify. So become 3 pi. Then over here, now sub in 0 minus 0, which we don't need to write. So actually the answer will be this part. I mean, but still need to over 2 because the other 2 got simplified. Okay? Something like this. This is the answer. So, actually, for this question, you can make it very complicated. You also can make it simple. And unit. So let me just say again. KC is kilocoulombs. Okay.
So method 4. Now for the previous methods, we have all used those, well, polar coordinates. Those are quite simple. Maybe this time we can try something more difficult. That is the Cartesian coordinates. And for these questions, first thing you think of, draw the graph. Like this. And then let's say that the center is somewhere here. Then we can draw the x-axis and that's y-axis. Here's the origin. Okay, so at this part is 1. Here is a negative 1. Here is a 1. And here is a negative 1. Like this. So this is what our graph is like. As given, it is a circle. Now, this Cartesian coordinates. Firstly, I'll start with what we have. So this is the integral region. And we have sigma x, y, dx, dy. And this is equal to, maybe I want first with respect to x. And here we can put in already. Now one thing that we'll want to know, the boundaries. So according to this, it says this part, we have x plus minus. So this part is obviously a minus. Square root 1 minus y squared. So then this part will be a x equals the positive version is the square root 1 minus y squared. Like this. Okay, so that means this part is a negative and this part is a positive. And this part for the y, we have negative 1 all the way up to a 1. Like this. Okay, next. For these parts, well, we can start integrating. We're all writing in the next row. So when we start integrating, here's an active 1 and a 1. So 1, it will become an x. X squared will become a 1/3 x cubed. Then y squared, you have an x, y squared. And this is x times y squared. Then you need to start from negative square root 1 minus y squared all the way to square root 1 minus y squared. Dy. Okay. Now the next part is to sub them in. Okay, so summing, you realize odd power, odd power, odd power. We can take a 2 out first. So that means you have a 2. the integral from negative 1 all the way to 1. Then at this part, it's a square root 1 minus y squared plus 1 third. And at this part, another bracket. So we'll go for a square bracket here. It is a 1 minus y squared. Then square root 1 minus y squared. Then you have 2 plus, so x. Now y squared, I can write that in front first in order not to get confused. So we have something like this. Then when you see this part, we don't like that square root staying there. It makes our working difficult. So maybe we could use some method to change that. Okay, and for this, I will just draw out what they are like, so they go in this order. Like just for example, we take this box. So that means for this box, we'll need to add them up. Keep adding them up. Okay. So that is actually what is like here. So get back to this part. We can add something. Well, 1 minus something makes you think of a trigonal identity. So actually for this trigonal identity, we can sort of let y be maybe sine theta. Well, yeah, the trigonal identity. Sine squared x plus cosine squared x will be equal to 1. Yeah, you can use that here. And let's try to find dy. We don't need to find what theta equals because at last we need to sub this in, not this. So here is cosine theta d theta. And here would be, so theta is here. If this is for negative 1, that means it will be for negative pi over 2. Then if this is a 1, that means it's a pi over 2. Okay, now at this part. So what we'll have is, let's try to sub that in. Like this. And then inside there is, so this part, that is cosine theta plus 1/3. So this is a cosine squared theta times a cosine theta, so it's a cosine cubed theta, and then plus, so this plus part will have sine squared theta, then cosine theta, then d theta. Like this. Wait a second, one thing. There. Okay, so now this part is complete. Now one thing that you realize here, I will write this 2 first because later we'll need to change it. Cosine theta, cosine cube theta, sine square theta, cosine theta, and here's another cosine theta. Now about these boundaries, did you realize something? We could actually just halve it. Because that they are symmetric and this is also, it's odd function, right? Well, it's actually like even. So this is from 0 all the way to pi over 2. Like this. And then here is a cosine squared theta plus 1/3 cosine to the power of 4 theta. Then we can plus. So here's a sine squared. square theta, and then a cosine square theta. Like this. Okay, so we do have something like this. Then next, it would be equal to, we can try to separate them now. Then you have something like this. Okay, so cosine square theta. Well, we can't integrate that straight away. So we might want to use our double angle formula. So that over 2 we have put here. So then this would be able to straight away change into a 2. So for that cosine square, it would be this thing. So we have a 1, okay, for cosine it will be a plus, cosine 2 theta, d theta, then plus, so plus, now plus what? We have 4 over 3, wait, this part, 2 times of that double angle, now here over there are 2 times, so it become 1 plus cosine 2 theta square d theta. Then at this part, yeah, we want to use something different, but because here it's a double angle formula for cosine, right now at this part we can use double angle formula for sine. So here, okay, to all that, no more. Integrate from 0 to pi over 2. So we have a sine. Now here it's a sine square 2 theta, d theta. Like this. Then next, we have 2 integrate from 0 to pi over 2. But you actually can combine this part with the 1 and this part with the 1/3. So that would become 7 over 3. Like this, then d theta, then plus, so at this part you have sine, well you need a half, so that's why the 2 is gone, 0 all the way to pi over 2, like this. Okay, the next part, cosine 2 theta. Okay, 2 of the cosine 2 theta. 2 is used up here, so it's a 1/3 sine 2 theta. Then you need to integrate from 0 to pi over 2. Then the last here, there's 2 more. So still have to plus 1/3 integrate from 0 to pi over 2. Then is cosine square 2 theta. So next, plus, now this part we can use the double angle formula for cosine. Now at this part we need a half. So now this will change. You have a 1 minus instead of a plus. So it is a cosine 4 theta. Then d theta. So firstly, this part over 2, so 7 pi over 6 already, 0 don't care. Sine pi, so sine pi is 0, 0 minus 0 plus 0 minus 0. This part totally don't even care. then plus. Now this part. Double angle formula again. Okay, this part actually gets a little bit quite confusing, but you just have to be very careful and then you can get it. So now you have a 1, then plus cosine 4 theta d theta. Then plus, so this part we can make it the same still. Then this part we can combine them. So 7 pi over 6, then your plus. So 1/6 plus 1/2, 2/3. Yep. Then it's integrate from 0 to 1/2 pi d theta. Then at this part, you have to plus. So this is a cosine 4 theta. That means you need a 1 over 24 for this. So 1 over 24, then integrate from 0 to 1/2 pi. Cosine 4 theta d 4 theta. Then minus. So this part you have to minus a, okay, also need 4 here, that means the 1 over 8 now. 0 to 1/2 pi, then here is cosine 4 theta d 4 theta, like this. Okay, now down here we have a 7 pi over 6, then plus, so here's a new one, 2 over 3 times pi over 2, pi over 3, then plus 1 over 24 sine 4 theta, then you need to start from 0 to pi over 2, like this, and then minus. So this part minus would be 1 over 8. Then after this, you will have sine 4 theta, the integral from 0 to pi over 2. So that means that last 0, 0, 0, and 0, that means your final answer. So here's the over 6. Okay, we'll just move it there. So at this part, over 6, 9, that means that 3 pi over 2. So the final answer that you should get is a 3 pi over 2. So this answer that you should get. And we also got this answer for the past two lessons. Yeah, so this is definitely correct. We have used different methods to check it and they're all right. So right now in this lesson I cleared so far. Okay, well this kind of method I'll just use once because different parts you can change with different ways. Like for example, if you don't want this kind of substitution, you might want to change it. There are a lot of ways for this, but I'll just use one as this kind of demonstration. Okay, so I hope that you're clear for this lesson. Okay, so we'll see you in the next lesson, and if you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So goodbye, and thank you for your watching.